叫罗望林，罗马的罗，希望的望，双木林，望着一片森林的意思。
你从哪里来？
我从湖南省长沙来。
为了生存你做了什么？
为了生存啊，我找了一份工作。
你是什么时候来到深圳的？
我是1998年来到深圳的。
你在深圳住了多久？
住了20年了。
你计划在深圳住多久？
我想我这辈子都会住在深圳哦，我好喜欢这里。
第一个从你的家来到深圳的是谁？
就是我。
他们是什么时候来的？
我是1998年来的呀，我的弟弟是2000年来的，我的父母是2003年来的。
你带了你的家人来到深圳吗？
对呀、啊，来了，他们都来了。
你的文化水平是多少？
我的文化水平，我是大学毕业。
你觉得因为你的文化水平，所以住在深圳更简单吗？
对，很容易。因为我是学历高的人，所以比较容易。
在深圳找一份工作很难吗？
对我而言并不难。
你为什么选择来深圳？
我喜欢这是一个海滨的城市，年轻，朝气蓬勃，阳光明媚，四季如春。
你来到深圳有特别的原因吗？
没有哎，我很向往这里，我要实现我的梦想，这就是特别的原因吧。
描述你的家乡。
我的家乡很美哦，风景如画，四季分明，山清水秀。
你的家乡和深圳有什么不同？
我的家乡，有很清脆的山，有很碧绿的水，鱼米之乡，也会下雪，很冷。可是它没有深圳发达。
当你来到深圳时，你需要学习一门新的语言吗？
要，当然了，深圳是不会讲普通话的时候。
那很难吗？
对我而言，学习新的语言并不难，因为我觉得我是一个很会学习的人哦。
你觉得你和你的家人移到深圳很难吗？
我也没有觉得很难，一切都很自然，顺其自然，水到渠成的事情。
在深圳你面对了什么困难？
困难就是太热了，夏天很长，永远都不下雪，很冷很热。深圳很热，我们家乡是冷的。还有就是要学习新的文化和语言，英语和粤语。
学习新的文化和新的生活方式很难吗？
其实刚开始会有点难的，但是我觉得我是很聪明的人，所以没有觉得特别的难，很容易就学会了，很快就学会了。
你的家庭有特别的节日或传统吗？
有，我们是一个传统的家庭。我们崇尚的是儒家的文化，要孝顺，要善良，要仁义。
你还在深圳继续那些传统或节日吗？
当然了，我们这些传统跟节日我要遗传给我的孩子，世世代代传递下去，这个是很好的节日。
你从你的家乡你带了什么重要的东西吗？
从我的家乡带来了辣椒。
它对你的意义是什么？
让我 能够活下去。
你为什么带它？
因为它是很美味的食物。
你觉得移民怎样改变了深圳？
移民啊，移民就是因为我们都是移民嘛，我们就会去努力学习，我们会勤奋工作嘛，我们会积极向上嘛，所以我们会与时俱进嘛，所以我们改变深圳。
你觉得这些改变是好的还是坏的？
当然是好的，很好呀，非常好，非常好。只是说我们不要再继续破坏环境了，保护动物。
为什么？
因为很多最初的工业污染的环境河流，那现在我们要把那些有高污染的工业全部要撤到很边远的地方去，我们要走高科技的路线，不要去走那些低品质低产能又破坏环境的工业，我们要去走高科技的路线，这样就不会破坏环境，就能保护环境，青蓝天白云草地和树木，为子孙后代造福。
你觉得深圳的未来是怎么样的？
哇，我很有信心，我觉得深圳的未来一定是非常美好的，而且是欣欣向荣的，一直会越来越好的，将来一定会超过美国的硅谷，是个高科技的城市。
谢谢你的采访。
不用谢。
The interview taught me about immigration in Shenzhen is to level of education is very high people. Moving to Shenzhen is not very hard because they have very high level of education. So maybe they know how to speak Chinese. Adapting to Shenzhen's challenges are weather and food.I think these are challenges for my mother because weather in my mom's hometown is cold and Shenzhen is hot. So weather is the challenge my mother faces. And my mother says she thinks chili is delicious, but Shenzhen's food is not very spicy. It is seafood. So I think my mother maybe need to eat bland seafood. This might be hard for her.Positive parts of adapting to Shenzhen is many people migrate to Shenzhen and they have many jobs. Some people are construction workers and they build high buildings in Shenzhen. And some make road in Shenzhen and they all make Shenzhen a very high-tech city.My mother's immigration story is similar to After Peaches because she also came with her family, and my mother also needed to learn a new language and culture. My mother's immigration story is different from After Peaches is because my mother didn't move to another country. People didn't treat her badly. My mother earns enough money.And she thinks learning a new language is easy. Also, her work is not dangerous, and it is not hard for her to find a good job. My mother's immigration story is similar to I am Fan Yusu because they both enjoy reading and have an education, and they both find a good job because she knows how to read.My mother is different from I am Fan Yusu because she didn't move to Beijing and her job is not a babysitter. She didn't run away from her hometown. I think my mother only gives one perspective. The missing viewpoints are how poor working class people feel about moving to Shenzhen. People who don't know how to read and speak the language and don't have education had a hard time moving to Shenzhen. In Demand on the Street articles from That's PRB magazine, the e-bike taxi driver said they cannot find job. They think moving to Shenzhen is hard because they can't make enough money. In my migrant worker journal, my character Wu Yimei thinks moving to Shenzhen is easy because she can speak Mandarin and she finds a street sweeping job quickly. But the street sweeping job's salary is little. This makes moving to Shenzhen too hard. In I Am Fan Yunsu thinks moving to Beijing is hard because she walks slowly. She thinks other people can finish half hour work. She cannot finish in 3 hours. My mother's immigration story is different from migrant workers. She does not have the same challenges because she earns a good salary. She is university and found a job easily.